This show is proudly partnered and supported by the Association of Ghana Industries AGI, TechnoServe Engine, and the African Youth in Entrepreneurship Program AYAP. Hello and welcome to another episode of Mpuntuo Bofo, the show on which we promote businesses and enterprises and try to encourage you to patronize made in Ghana goods and services. Today on the show, we're going to feature a unique Abofo. He's a designer of houses or a consultant who constructs and designs houses with facilities to harvest natural resources which are in abundance in Ghana, but which we let go to waste. What am I talking about? We'll get to know in a jiffy. Before then, let me acknowledge our partners, the Association of Ghana Industries, AGI, TechnoServe Engine, and the Youth in Entrepreneurship Program, AYAP. When we come back, we meet our very unique designer.
Like the goodness of the creation story in Eden, so is the goodness of the fresh fruits, herbs and vegetables from the Eden tree. Fresh herbs, fruits and vegetables grown with natural organic compost and clean fresh water. An adoring, spacious and welcoming restaurant serving life-giving dishes. Eden Tree Limited, First Boti Junction, Spinders Road. Eden Tree, Eduane Perfie.
Providing the Montessori system of education, supplemented with facilities and extracurricular activities designed to bring the best in the natural interest and abilities of the child. Let your child acquire that total and complete education where children are taught and developed to soar in their natural field of endeavor. Eagle International School, West Lagos, soaring with excellence and dignity.
The human body is 70% water. If denied water, the body dies. Yes, water is life. Yes, drink water, but not just any kind of water. Yes, a truly pure, clean, refreshing water. Yes, natural mineral water. Health is our concern. Care is a watchword. Yes, natural mineral water. Contact us. Yes.
Blue Ribbon Exclusive Households, a one-stop shop for quality domestic and industrial and kitchen household ware. Brands from various parts of the world, synonymous with quality to suit every class of kitchen and household. Dinner sets, stainless steel cookware with reinforced base for every conceivable use. Bone china mats and tea sets, original polysilicate Paris bowls, numerous quality wares for the home, hotel and other uses. Blue Ribbon Exclusive Household. Lowum Street, South Jolly, opposite Unit Flora. Blue Ribbon Exclusive Household. Quality for good life and health.
Our next Abofo is another enterprising entrepreneur. He's an architect by profession and he specializes in the design of eco-friendly homes. That is, homes that incorporate water harvesting facilities or solar panel and solar harvesting facilities. Let's go and talk to him and see what he has for us. To get some technical insight into the designing of ecologically friendly homes with particular focus on rainwater harvesting functionalities, we visited the offices in East Legon of Ethnic International Development Consultants, an architectural company, and had a chat with the CEO, Mr. Derban, an architect who specializes in the design and construction of ecologically friendly houses.
Now, in looking at rainwater harvesting, there are a few facts that we must understand to appreciate what it's about. And it all basically hinges on the amount of rainfall that an area receives, say, per year. And the fact is that if you have 1 inch of rain, rainfall is measured in inches meteorologically, you have 1 inch of rainfall on a 90 square meter house, which is like a two-bedroom house, you can trap 600 gallons. So if you have a four-bedroom house, you know, three, four-bedroom small house, and you're having 2 inches of rainfall, you can store 1,200 gallons per year. Now, in Ghana, roughly, we could receive something like 20 inches of rainfall, you know, in this country. That means that with a three or four bedroom house, you are storing 24,000 gallons of water a year. Now, let's compare that to the consumption of a house, you know, such as the one I've designed here. If you have four people in a house, let's say they use, or six people, they use 30 gallons of water a day, flushing, washing, cooking, everything, times 365. You are likely to be using 43,000 gallons a year compared to 24. This means that the rain water harvesting can augment our water supply needs greatly if we really consider it right from the design stage. And that's what we are being a proponent of. We are trying to look at rain water harvesting from the design stage. Not when you finish the house and then you start looking, where will I dig a tank? But trying to incorporate things in the design. The best type of roof to use for rainwater harvesting is a metal roof. The best is aluminium. The concrete roofs, the concrete tiles, you know, the water runs off, the coloring runs off, the sediment runs off. And so you find that your storage tank, you know, has a lot of sediment. But with the aluminium, especially if you have what we call first wash, it washes the rain off and the dirt off before it begins to store the water. So the best is aluminium, you know. And then the angle, whatever angle it is, it will by all means flow off. But it shouldn't be so steep so that it will miss the gutters. And you must have gutters that are, you know, adequately wide enough to be able to trap most of the water, at least 80% of the water, because the by all means run off, especially if there's a heavy downpour. So you should have your gutters, you know, wide enough, and then you should have an aluminium roof or some other roof that can take the rainwater without sedimenting, you know, washing the sediment off. And then the pipes, you know, you can have PVC pipes, you know, that take it to the storage tank, you know, which is built in the earth. It can be a PVC, a specialized PVC tank, or it can be a concrete tank. You know, you can filter it before it goes into the tank, and then you can filter it when you are pumping it up into the overhead tank to be used. You know, and the type of filters that you use, there are quite a number of different type of filters that you can use. I've designed houses for clients where I've put a tank under the dining room. Another place to place is under the garage, you know, but of course it must be well reinforced. The idea is think about it, plan it into the design stage. Then it doesn't become an extra cost when you are digging. It's part of the foundation. These examples I'm giving to you were built on the side of a hill, so it's easy for you to access. They just use the slope, flatten it out, and they can enter the tank very easily. It must be accessible, it must be cleanable, it must have what you call a washout at the bottom. You can open it and wash it out, you know, but it's not like there's a hole in your living room which you can enter and it's a tank. No, not that. It all depends on design. We must understand that sooner or later, there will be what we call environmental crimes. And one environmental crime will be using potable water that comes from our tap to wash your car. That is a crime. Using potable water that people don't have to drink to water your flowers. That it can also be a crime. punishable crime. You see? And then when we get that away, you know, will these ideas will begin to flow into our system a lot more easily. You know. So it then says that if you have a rain water spout on top of your roof, that just takes the rain off your water and just pours it onto the ground. You know, that is a design crime. That is also a crime. You know, we must make the effort to store the water that comes from the rain and use it for example, toilet flushing. One toilet flush can take about 1 gallon of water, or slightly less than 1 gallon of water per flush. Whether soil or urine, it's all 1 gallon of water going. For all the 6 people in the house, that's over 15 gallons going, 16, 20 gallons going a day. Now, that water is drinkable water. But if we can channel our rainwater into cisterns and it can be pumped to fill the toilets and used, now that saves us a lot of drinking water, potable water. Currently, I'm designing a prototype for an eco home, an ecological home, and a total eco home. That is that it comprises of rainwater harvesting, solar electricity, water filtration, solar water heating, and natural light. This is the prototype of the eco home. You know, this is the roof plan showing the rainwater distribution. You know, these are the tanks that will be overhead, that will be from the rainwater tank and the fresh water tank. The water supply units, that's the rainwater tank being pumped through a filter and then being distributed to the tank overhead, and then being distributed also into the shower, the sinks, and the toilets. You know. And then also we have the solar hot water distribution. There are solar panels on top of the roof that also distribute hot water to the appliances. And there's solar electricity. There are solar panels on top of the roof, and there's an inverter that converts sunlight into electricity. This is a three-dimensional view of the house. See, it just looks like a normal home, a beautifully designed home, you know. And then we see a large rain gutter, you know, that collects the rain and sends it into an underground tank or below the garage. Then also there's a overhead tank, and there are solar panels on top of the roof, and you can see better from this side. Here too, you can see the large rain gutter taking water into the underground tank and being pumped above into the overhead tank. And these are all sketches that have been made, you know, on the same design. It's about a 4-bedroom house and a family space. You might make a budget for about 1,000 Ghana CDs, 1,200 Ghana CDs and over. For the rainwater spouts, the lines, but not the system. There's a rainwater system, you know, and then you need to invest into the filters. You can go as far as you want, but then you'll be spending something like that and above. Nothing comparable to the lights you need into your house, Nothing compared to the other fittings that you will need to buy. You know, it's comparable to those things. And this one saves you. It's not something that you consume. It actually saves you consumption. You see, that's the way you look at these things, you know. When you're looking at the cost, you look at what saves you the money in these environmental houses. You look at what saves you the money instead of the consumption and how much you just spend on it, you know, and perpetually spending on it, you know. It's like lights and bulbs, you know, just using it for light. And using sunlight or natural light, you know, through transparent roofing, something like that. You save off lighting when you use those things. You know. But you will still spend something, some 1,000 Ghana CDs and over. from that level onwards. If you want a very good one that will last forever. It's those who use it that can testify to it, you know.
Basically, we harvest rainwater because it's difficult getting water in this area. And as you can see, we need to buy water to do our house chores, wash our cars, and all the household things. But it's beneficial when you harvest rain because you need to buy a smaller quantity of water that you can drink. And we use these ones for washing the cars, flushing the toilet, and even watering the gardens and washing as well. And sometimes we do, it's good. Sometimes we even drink some, and it doesn't affect us that much. So it's quite good when you harvest rainwater.
We don't buy much water. Maybe in the year we buy water like 2 or 3 times in a year. And the rest of the year we have our own water. We don't have to worry about getting water. The capacity of the underground tank is about 4,000 gallons. So most of the time during the rainy season it's very full. So it's about 4,000 gallons.
Like the goodness of the creation story in Eden, so is the goodness of the fresh fruits, herbs and vegetables from the Eden tree. Fresh herbs, fruits and vegetables grown with natural organic compost and clean fresh water. An adoring, spacious and welcoming restaurant serving life-giving dishes. Eden Tree Limited, 1st Boti Junction, Spinders Road, Eden Tree, Ediane Perfie. The human body is 70% water. If denied water, the body dies. Yes, water is life. Yes, drink water, but not just any kind of water. Yes, a truly pure, clean, refreshing water. Yes, natural mineral water. Health is our concern. Care is a watchword. Yes, natural mineral water. Contact us. Yes.
Providing the Montessori system of education, supplemented with facilities and extracurricular activities designed to bring the best in the natural interest and abilities of the child. Let your child acquire that total and complete education where children are taught and developed to soar in their natural field of endeavor. Eagle International School, West Lagos, soaring with excellence and dignity. I believe I can
Blue Ribbon Exclusive Household, a one-stop shop for quality domestic and industrial and kitchen household ware. Brands from various parts of the world synonymous with quality to suit every class of kitchen and household. Dinner sets, stainless steel cookware with reinforced base for every conceivable use. Bone china mugs and tea sets, original polysilicate Paris bowls, numerous quality wares for the home, hotel and other uses. Blue Ribbon Exclusive Household. Bloom Street, South Jolu, opposite Unique Flora. Blue Ribbon Exclusive Household. Quality for good life and health.
Mpuntuo Bofo, an innovative SME promotion and micro business development TV show. A principal business, company, or investor known on the show as the Abofo will be extensively promoted, and as part of the promotional strategy, the Abofo may opt to support a small or micro business grow from one level to the other right on TV. Mpuntuo Bofo, an innovative business promotion show, the first of its kind ever on Ghanaian TV. Whatever the nature of business, Mpuntuo Bofo will creatively promote it. And if you opt to support or mentor a small business grow on TV, you get extra promotional mileage. Mpuntuo Bofo, every Monday at 9:30 p.m. on GTV.
That has been another intriguing episode of Mpuntuo Bofo. I would like to reiterate that this show is for the promotion of industry and businesses in Ghana and for the promotion of the consumption of Made in Ghana products and services. If you have a business, then let me humbly suggest that you need some kind of exposure, and we are here to give you a helping hand. Just call us, irrespective of the size of your business or irrespective of the size of your budget, give us a call and we will come over and together plan how to effectively make your story known to the ends of Ghana and beyond Ghana to Africa, because GTV is the station with the widest coverage and GTV is on DSTV. Next week, we'll meet another innovative above when I can promise you that. But before I go, let me once again acknowledge our partners, the Association of Ghana Industries, AGI, TechnoServe Engine, and the African Youth in Agripreneurship Program, AYAP. I encourage you to bring home something made in Ghana this week. Until I come your way again with another innovative episode of Mpuntuo Bofo, it is bye from me and the crew, Mauna for me.
Lubonye kafu Yehova, eye nusia nusi lemengela, mikafu wepen koko kwela, aseye hawo.